A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 25th May, on the front page you have, ahead of forming new government, Modi submits resignation. He meets President Ramnath Kovind to visit Varanasi before his swearing in next week. So you can see the Prime Minister Narendra Modi was re-elected, and now the process of a new government need to be put in place has begun. The ministers of the union cabinet and the meeting took place, and they passed a resolution to dissolve the 16th Lok Sabha and tender their resignations. So fresh appointments would be done now. Then this is, blaze kills 21 students at coaching center in Surat. Victims were trapped on top floor, 17 were injured and 3 are missing. So the massive fire which took place here in Surat, in an illegally constructed building for which permission was there only up to first floor, but on the top floor here, third floor and the top floor terrace, this coaching institute worked, and a huge dome was illegally constructed on the terrace, and an AC duct here, a short circuit took place in it, because of which a massive fire came up and many children, who all the students, they were in their teens, many children jumped off from the windows here. The fire brigade had come with only one small ladder. It had reached till here, and it did not have any fire safety net as such too, in which they could have caught the jumping children. Three of the children died, succumbing to the injuries after the jump. 19 children are said to have been killed in the blaze of inside the complex, and 16 of them were girls. And this is, after failing to deliver Brexit, Theresa May calls it a day. So this is UK Prime Minister Theresa May. So actually she was fighting back tears and said she would quit after failing to deliver Brexit. So a new Prime Minister would be put in place, and he'll try to pursue a cleaner break with the European Union. So Brexit has not been agreed upon in UK, and the deal has to be agreed upon between European Union and UK too. The deal between European Union and UK, which Theresa May clinched, is not accepted in her country. So she finally quits now. And this is, Orisha tribal woman to become youngest ever MP. So this is Chandrani Murmu, 25 years, 11 months and 8 days old. She won from Koinjar Lok Sabha seat on BJD, Biju Janata Dal ticket in Orisha. So she has become the youngest ever MP in Lok Sabha's history. On page 9 you have, Musa was working to merge Hizb JEM into mega group. So Al-Qaeda affiliated Ansar Ghazwat ul-Hind chief Zakir Rashid Bhatt alias Zakir Musa, another name for him was Zakir Musa, he was killed by security forces in an encounter in South Kashmir's Pulwama. So he was tasked to put together the group comprising Hizbul Mujahideen and Jaish-e-Mohammed. So the terrorists should be merged together. So he was considered a mini icon in Kashmir Valley after death of Hizbul Mujahideen commander Burhan Wani in an encounter in July 2016, since when the Kashmir situation has become volatile. So he was active in and around Pulwama, and he has been encountered and killed. So Musa, he was buried amid protests and shut down in Kashmir Valley. So despite restrictions, huge crowds gathered at the funeral. And this is, higher education to get a boost with rupees 1.5 lakh crore action plan. So it has been announced by Ministry of Human Resource Development that this will be one of the first new initiatives of the government. It plans to launch an ambitious 1.5 lakh crore action plan to improve the quality and accessibility of higher education over the next 5 years. So of course the question is that when do we target higher education, when education for all at the lower levels is not up to the mark. So first children at lower levels have to be getting admission, enrollments, and their quality of education should improve, then we can talk of improving higher education, improve the quality and accessibility of higher education. And below you have, center bans terror outfit based out of Bangladesh. So this is Jamaatul Mujahideen Bangladesh. So this Bangladesh based terror outfit has been banned by the central government under the anti-terror law, Unlawful Activities Prevention Act. it is said it was engaged in radicalization of youths in India. On the editorial page, the first editorial is signals from the states. So this is regarding the four assembly election results. So it says this cast a light on the political strategies and voter behavior. So along with the Lok Sabha elections, elections for four state legislative assemblies were also held. They were Arunachal Pradesh, Sikkim, Odisha and Andhra Pradesh. So you can see in Odisha, Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik has won a fifth consecutive term. So it was a Biju Janata Dal's sweeping victory. In Sikkim, it was Pawan Kumar Chamling, the longest serving CM in India. He will be moving out after his Sikkim Democratic Front lost. And BJP won the assembly elections in Arunachal Pradesh. So this is there. Also in Andhra Pradesh, you can see YSR Congress, it made a spectacular victory in Andhra Pradesh. Then below you have full circle. So this is regarding how the kilogram has come to be defined once again in terms of universal constants. So this we had discussed in news also. It will be after, you know, on the basis of Planck's constant that kilogram would be defined. Then the lead article is no easy solutions for the Congress. So again, this is political, you can skip it. And the next article, the NDA has its task cut out. It says it must improve conditions of supply and facilitate and the move away from agricultural jobs to raise farmers' income. So this is what the government should do ahead in this 5-year term. That is mentioned here. And on op-ed page, on Fridays you have this coverage. On Saturdays you have this particular coverage on a particular issue. So it says it's time to take stock of the electoral process. It says the general election saw serious questions being posed to the election commission. The 17th Lok Sabha must deliberate on them. So issues with respect to the conduct of the election commission during the elections. So those issues are discussed here. Others are political, you can skip it. On international page, you have this coverage on Brexit. The Theresa May, she is quitting, we saw on the front page. So this detailed coverage here. And this is US to deploy 1,500 additional troops to West Asia. So it says this is prudent response to credible threats from Iran. So this is clear escalation of tensions in West Asia. And this is Trump Pelosi trade barbs over impeachment talks. So Speaker Nancy Pelosi, she questioned the president's mental fitness and President Trump called her crazy. So these were the exchanges which took place, angry exchanges between the two. On business page you have SEBI panel moots changes to FPI rules. So this is regarding foreign portfolio investment. So SEBI has proposed liberalized investment cap and review of prohibited sectors and allowing off-market transactions. And this is RBI mulls liquidity buffer for shadow banks. So to a liquidity buffer, the liquidity coverage ratio will be introduced for large non-banking financial companies to help tackle liquidity issues in the sector. They have this will be for NBFCs with 5,000 crore assets. Then on the last page, there is no important news. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs and PDF for current affairs, you can visit our website asr.com. Thank you.